It's been said, and you already know that your CLI, your FortiGate CLI, is your best friend, and it is powerful. You can do just about anything with it. The following is the CLI logic guide. How does it work, and what is the logic between the different configuration commands and the get commands and the show commands that you see all over? So let's start. If you want to understand your command line, start thinking of it as a tree. A tree with branches. Now, the main branches are config, get, show, execute, and diagnose. Those are the five main branches of your command line. Now, each branch has its purpose. For example, the config branch. The config branch allows you to configure objects. Now, what are objects? Let's look at it at the command line. All right, so let's start. We're using the 6.4 JavaScript CLI, which looks much better than other version. So we have said that we're using the config command to configure different objects. What is an object? For example, our system is an object, but every object also has a sub-object. What can be the sub-object of the FortiGate system? Well, it can be our DNS server. This can also be our DHCP server. It can be our interfaces. So let's start with two examples. The first one is our DNS, and the second one is the interface sub-object. So if we use the config system DNS, that's the command, that's the object, and that's the sub-object, and press enter. Now, every object is built actually from a table of variables and values. Now, if we use the show command, we will see only the default configuration, which currently is the primary DNS and the secondary DNS. If we use the get command, we will see all, it will list all the table entries with the different variables and values. Now, if we want to set or edit an entry, we can use the set command. The set command is actually a sub command that is used to edit different variables with different values. So one variable is the primary DNS. So let's edit the primary DNS to 8888. All right, now let's just use the show command, and we can see that we have actually changed the variable, the primary DNS variable, to another value using the set command. So again, we have the config command, we have the show command that will show us the changes to the default configuration, we have the get command that will actually list all the table entries, we have the set command that will allow us to add up values to the different variables that we have here in the table itself, and we also have what is known as the edit. The edit is also a subcommand, and it allows us to edit different entries. So let's just clear up the page, and let's use another command, which is the config system interface. Again, we have the command, we have the object, and we have the sub object. Now, if I'll press enter, then I can also use the edit. The edit is also a subcommand that allows us to get into specific entries. What can be an entry in the system interface? The different interfaces, such as port 1 or port 2. So let's just use port 1, which is an object, an interface object. Let's just press enter. And here again, we can set the different values of that interface. We can also see what is already configured on that interface. And we can also use the get command that will list all the table entries.